July 27th, 2021. The LyondellBasell La Porte Complex in La Porte, Texas. Approximately 164,000 pounds of acetic acid mixture erupted from equipment when three contract workers inadvertently removed critical components of a valve. All three workers were sprayed with the acetic acid mixture, fatally injuring two.
Unfortunately, this is not the first time that simple maintenance of a plug valve ended in tragedy. Our report and recommendations aim to help prevent incidents like this one from reoccurring.
LyondellBasell is a plastics, chemicals, and refining company that owns and operates facilities in 32 countries. The company's La Porte, Texas complex is the world's third largest producer of acetic acid, a flavor enhancer and food preservative. Acetic acid is a corrosive liquid that can cause severe skin burns and eye damage upon exposure and can be harmful if inhaled. On July 24, 2021, an operations technician discovered a small leak from piping in the complex's acetic acid unit. The piping was located upstream of the unit's acetic acid reactor. Shortly after the leak was discovered, the shutdown of an adjacent process unit required the acetic acid unit to also shut down. Personnel decided to use the opportunity provided by the shutdown to fix the leak. To isolate the affected pipe section, company personnel decided to close the plug valve located between the leaking pipe and the nearby acetic acid reactor. LyondellBasell planned to remove the valve's actuator, which is equipment that opens and closes the valve, so that they could lock the valve in the closed position. Since 2019, LyondellBasell had used a third-party contractor turned to specialty companies for general mechanical and maintenance services at the facility. Turn 2 communicated to LyondellBasell that it had a night crew that was qualified and available to remove the actuator. But LyondellBasell did not have a procedure detailing how to remove the actuator, and neither LyondellBasell nor Turn 2 trained the contract personnel on how to remove the actuator. On the evening of July 27th, a Turn 2 foreman and two pipe fitters began working to remove the actuator from the plug valve. In doing so, they inadvertently removed pressure-retaining fasteners that were holding the valve cover in place. These fasteners should not have been removed to uninstall the actuator. Not recognizing that they had compromised the integrity of the valve, the team continued to remove the actuator and associated equipment, including a coupler. But the coupler was stuck on the valve stem and could not be easily slid off. Therefore, the workers decided to use a tool to attempt to forcibly remove the coupler. The combination of forces from the tool and the process fluid pressure inside the plug valve caused the compromised valve to fail. The unfastened valve cover and plug forcibly ejected from the valve body. A chemical mixture, primarily composed of acetic acid, rapidly erupted through the open valve. The entire contents of the acetic acid reactor, roughly 164,000 pounds of hot acetic acid mixture, emptied through the open unplugged valve. All three Turn 2 workers were sprayed by the acetic acid mixture. The Turn 2 foreman and one pipe fitter were fatally injured from chemical burns and inhalation of the release. The third worker was seriously injured. 29 others sought medical treatment. The Chemical Safety Board launched an investigation and found two safety issues contributed to the severity of the incident. They are valve design to prevent human error and providing workers with conditions, procedures, and training to safely conduct work. The first safety issue is valve design to prevent human error. During its investigation, the CSB discovered that there had been at least four other serious incidents that were the result of workers inadvertently removing pressure-retaining components from a plug valve while attempting to remove an actuator. All of these previous incidents resulted in fatalities or serious injuries. The CSB believes that the recurrence of these types of incidents points to the need to redesign plug valves so that it is very difficult to accidentally remove pressure-retaining components.
The best way to address this type of incident would be by prevention through design of new plug valves. But in the meantime, facilities should clearly label pressure-retaining components on existing plug valves. For example, through color-coded paint and warning signs so that workers can identify them more easily.
As a result, the CSB made recommendations to the American Society of Mechanical Engineers and the American Petroleum Institute to revise their plug valve design standards to require facilities to clearly mark all existing plug valve pressure-retaining components and require that new plug valves be designed to prevent the inadvertent removal of pressure-retaining components. The second safety issue found by the CSB is providing workers with conditions, procedures, and training to safely conduct work. The CSB found that LyondellBasell did not thoroughly assess the risks of the actuator removal work to ensure that sufficient procedures and safeguards were in place to prevent exposure to process fluid.
At some facilities, a risk assessment may determine that depressurizing and de-inventorying equipment is required before removing plug valve actuating equipment.
The CSB also found that LyondellBasell failed to provide the turn two crew with a written procedure and allowed the work to be done without LyondellBasell's oversight because of the perceived simplicity of the actuator removal. Furthermore, the CSB determined that neither LyondellBasell nor Turn 2 trained the work crew on the steps necessary to safely remove the actuator.
Had LyondellBasell performed a risk assessment to ensure safeguards were in place during the actuator removal, as well as provided the Turn 2 work crew with written procedures, proper training, and oversight, this incident could have been prevented.
As a result, the CSB recommended that LyondellBasell update company policy documents to require that procedures are developed for properly removing actuating equipment from plug valves and to require verification that contractors are competent, adequately trained, and qualified to perform work.
As this tragic incident has shown us, even a simple task can turn deadly if it is not properly performed. It is time to improve the design of plug valves and take other protective actions, such as ensuring that clear markings are visible on all existing plug valve pressure-retaining components and workers are properly trained before conducting maintenance. Vital steps like these can go a long way in injury prevention and help save lives. Thank you for watching this CSB safety video.
For more information, please visit csb.gov.